go back up to the periodic table. Now, notice that I called this the organic table of elements. That's because I kind of tricked this periodic table out to help you guys a little bit. So I just want to introduce, just refresh you guys on how to read a periodic table and show you some special features that I put into this one. So first of all, notice that the periodic table has like 118 elements. There's way too many. Organic chemistry is the study of life, chemistry of life. And living systems are usually not made out of heavy metals, okay? You don't have like a plant that's made out of a bunch of like mercury and einsteinium and radioactive things. It's made out of like lightweight atoms. It's usually made out of the first and second row elements, or first and second period, okay? So we're really gonna focus on the ones that I shaded as bright. So you see all the bright ones on the screen up there? Those are the ones you want to focus on. I would recommend knowing them. I would recommend being familiar with where they are on the periodic table. Okay? So just a heads up. Okay? But all these other ones that I grayed out, don't worry about those so much. I'm never going to ask you, your professor's not going to ask you to know very specific things about them. All right? So in terms of metals, metalloids, nonmetals, don't worry about that too much. That's more inorganic chemistry and gen chem. In organic, we don't really care about categorizing atoms so much. But what really is important is knowing the groups that these atoms are in and knowing the periods that they're in. So remember that period is just the same thing as saying row. So if I ever say row, that means period. Group is the same thing as saying column. Okay? So if I ever say column 7, that means group 7. All right? And it's just important to know that you've basically got groups 1 through 8. Some of you guys might be wondering what happened down here. Why do these not get letters? And it's because these actually do get numbers, but they are the Bs. So this would be like 1B, it would be 1B, 2B, etc. Okay, so we don't really worry about those, we just worry about the As, alright? So that's something to keep in mind. I will be referring to these group numbers a lot. I'll just say group 7, group 6, group 5, stuff like that. And you should be familiar with what atoms are in which group. And don't worry, by doing lots of orgo, you'll get very familiar with it.